Now steady yourselves. We're about to look into the quirkier side of your letters and emails.
It's that time of the show, isn't it?
It is.
It's that time.
Very much Haydo's department. Yes. So I'm not sure if that's an endorsement or a warning.
Look, I think it's time for Haydo's mailbag, an amazing segment. They let me do this on one condition, that I answer as many of your questions as possible. So here goes. Good luck, everyone. Welcome to Haydo's mailbag. There's never any mail.
Hey, fair go.
Wellington's Eric Waghorn noticed something funny about his dog's dinner.
What's up with the Jimbo shrinkage?
Eric's pooch is feeling the pinch from a product shrinkage.
And we are feeding this poor shrinking fellow, Frankie here, a quarter of a pottle. When it shrinks, you give your dog a quarter of a pottle less, and we didn't notice.
Jimbo's dog food has gone from 900 grams to 800 grams.
Come on, Jimbo. Price hasn't changed.
Other viewers tell us the cat food has shrunk too. Jimbo's concede it's all about rising costs. We tried many options to maintain our pricing, but in the end we opted for a small change in pottle size so we could keep the same quality without a change to our recommended price.
Watchful eye in the beehive.
And if Frankie looks familiar, you're right. He used to work at Parliament.
He's been a very special part of this place.
Susie in Wairarapa sent us a silent movie. She's big on the small packets of grain waves. But how small is too small? 7 chips in total.
1.
We were curious too.
2.
So in the interests of research.
3.
Where do we look to?
4. 10.
Bluebird, who make grain waves, tell us they're sold by weight rather than chip count. And sometimes, the natural grain blend can produce a slightly heavier chip, which can result in fewer chips in the pack.
Some crumbs.
Susie says she may go back to bagging up her own.
Hey, Haydo.
Abigail Hamilton from Hawke's Bay wrote to us about the vexed issue of slicing cheese.
What's up with cheese slices these days? Well, I'm just trying to make my sandwich, and they keep breaking. This one broke, and now this one.
Abigail's mum sent us a gallery of broken cheese slices.
I'm not allowed to use a sharp knife because it's a bit dangerous at my age.
She says the Pam slicer is the most troublesome, a bargain at $3, but doesn't last.
Hey Abigail, my name is Mel. I'm from the Pam's team.
Pam's tell us they're looking into it.
We've got one of our quality specialists on it at the moment, testing the product quality. And in the meantime, we're going to send you a little something to make sure that you have the ultimate sandwich experience.
Pam sent Abigail a gift card, and in the meantime, their family continues its search for a decent cheese slicer because
the cheese is so expensive these days.
Fiona wrote to us furious about her whole earth monkfruit sweetener, a popular and healthy alternative to sugar. To my great disappointment, after having used it a couple of times, I read the ingredients to find out that the product is actually 99% erythritol and 1% monkfruit. Erythritol is a sugar alcohol used as a low-calorie sweetener, and overuse can give you gas. Meanwhile, Whole Earth tell us, monkfruit extract is approximately 200 times sweeter than sugar, so it's impractical to use by itself. That's why we combine it with erythritol, to make it easier to consume.
That's Haydo's mailbag. Better living, everyone.